My name is Scott Kane with IHSE USA. IHSE has been developing and manufacturing KVM solutions for 32 years based in Germany, with U.S. headquarters located in New Jersey for the past 10 years. In this session, I will be providing an overview of the IHSE system design and products. IHSE stands for Industrial Hardware Software Engineering. We manufacture high-performance KVM switches, extenders, and signal transmission products for video and data over long distances. The highest percentage of market share for IHSE is in the broadcast, post-production, field and mobile production segments, followed by defense and military, along with other commercial and industrial segments. For ease of doing business, IHSE is a GSA contract holder. KVM stands for keyboard, video, and mouse, used for the purpose of accessing multiple CPUs from one keyboard, video, and mouse without having to move to another location. There are many similar KVM solutions on the market. However, the simplicity and scalability of our design is why our customers choose IHSE over the competition. There are two different schools of thought when it comes to KVMs, the IHSE KVM solution or the IP KVM solution. Taking a look at the IP KVM solution first, this solution requires KVM transmitters and receiver extenders, along with an IP KVM management appliance and an IP switch, with possible annual licensing expenses per port. The IP switch is shared typically amongst all network users who are engaging in their own tasks and applications across the same IP network the KVM is using. Based on IP network bandwidth demand and only so much bandwidth available, the IP network may slow down, including the KVM video, typically causing latency between screen changes due to the lack of bandwidth required for scaling and higher video resolutions. Also, the risk of packet loss or jittery screens, which is considered unacceptable in a video, broadcast, production, field, or post-production environment. Now looking at the IHSE solution, we are a separate network, not IP-based. We use layer 2 on the OSI model, the MAC address layer, and we are considered a digital island where 100% bandwidth goes to signaling. There are no inherent IP bandwidth issues of latency, packet loss, or jittery screens. IHSE design is more secure based on no unauthorized access from IP network users potentially corrupting the IHSE network. Additionally, if the IP network goes down, the IHSE network stays up. And yes, you can access the IP network through the IHSE workstation at any time. Now a look at the IHSE network design. IHSE is a modular and scalable system to suit your exact needs, offering a 2, 4, 6, or 21 bay chassis. One advantage is our redundant power option. For example, 6-bay chassis are commonly placed throughout the CPU racks and offer front or rear power receptacles. An example of the 2-bay chassis, we have a main board which connects to every CPU and an optional upgrade board which offers serial, audio, or extended USB functions. This particular chassis also has a dual power supply option. The 474 series is DVI-D, the 481 is HDMI, the 482 DVI-DL, which is dual link, or DVI-DH, which is dual head. The 483 series is DisplayPort, and 4K as well, or a 490 Ultra series, which is full 4K resolutions, 4096 by 2160, at a real 60 Hz refresh, and a full color depth of 24-bit. For the main boards that we offer, each one has a redundant link option as well for mission critical production and control rooms. Our optional upgrade boards are most commonly the USB, the analog or digital audio, and the serial function boards. The 480C is a compact series which includes an available 8-port switch that fits in a 2, 4, 6, or 21 bay chassis for saving rack space. There are two different methods to access CPUs from the workstation console. The OSD, on-screen display, which can be accessed from any workstation, or the Tera tool, which is a GUI interface, allowing greater detail of configuration, which is included with every switch. You can simply click and drag connections or make any changes on the fly, within the user's access privileges. With any of our 480 series switches, you can matrix them up to 16 levels deep, from the smallest switch 8-port up to 576 ports, times 16. The first switch family to introduce is the Compact Series. Now this series comes in CAT-X fiber, hybrid, which is CAT-X and fiber in the same switch, uni, which is blank slots to customize with SFPs, being CAT-X fiber or mini BNCs for SDI, HD or 3G SDI, USB 3.0, or XV fiber, high speed, 6 gigabits per second. All 480 series switches have FlexPort technology, multi-signal support, Smart Connect, which based on being a MAC address switch, it automatically recognizes what's being plugged in and maps the extenders as well, making it the fastest KVM switch in the market. The second switch family is the Enterprise switch. The Enterprise switches are from 48 to 576 ports. These switches are even more flexible. Since we are MAC address based, our power supplies, cooling fans, I/O, and control modules are all hot swappable. Each module has a MAC address, which automatically identifies and configures the switch if any changes are made, meaning no IP configuration or lost time. The Enterprise switches come in sizes from 48 to 80, 160, 288, or 576 ports. The modules are 8 ports per module, and they come in CAT-X, fiber, XV fiber, or blanks for universal SFPs. The SFP card, as you can see, is fiber, mini BNCs, or CAT-X. The control system allows SDI follow for KVM as well. The 485 series is our repeater and cross-repeater solution. These are used to be cost-effective in the existing infrastructure. If the risers are fiber and then they go to CAT-X and the floors, then we simply go from fiber to CAT-X and the cross repeater, or vice versa. If you simply need to extend a CAT-X cable, we can double the distance by inserting a repeater. The 238 series are signal conversion modules, taking any existing device in the network that is an analog-based signal, we convert it to a digital signal to put it onto our network. The K476 series is a USB U-switch, which comes in 4 or 8 ports. It's used in the command and control or monitoring environments where you have multiple monitors lined up or stacked within an environment and gives you one keyboard and mouse to control all up to 8 monitors. Wherever that mouse lands or resides is the live session screen. Adversely, we can also provide a KVM for a multi-view solution where you have multiple screens in one monitor. Another cost-effective product we offer is the CWDM in a 4, 8, or 16 duplex fiber connection. Used for consolidating 4, 8, or 16 duplex fibers down to one and then breaking it out on the other end. This is commonly used at universities, going across a campus, or a large plant, as opposed to pulling additional cable, or connecting tie lines between mobile production trucks, or staging and rental companies use this for events. Now, quick summary to review the key IHSE differentiators. You purchase exactly what you need, the modular cards and within the chassis designs. No adapters needed to convert connectors. The main modules available in DVI-D, HDMI, DisplayPort, or VGA. The upgrade modules are optional to add analog or digital audio, USB, or serial. The optional upgrade modules come in analog or digital audio, USB, or serial connections for the following connectors. We offer a CAT-X or fiber repeater solution and cross repeaters. We can mix connector types between the CPU and console with or without a switch. If you have, for example, a CPU that is DVI-D, yet the console workstation is HDMI, we can connect directly via point-to-point or through a switch. IHSE offers optional redundancy, automatic failover for power and or data link, zero latency, no frame jitters or lost packets, 100% bandwidth goes to signaling, consistently 1 gigabit per port bandwidth, FlexPort technology, automatic configuration of switch ports via MAC address, no IP manager appliance expense, no IP ports to configure. Keyboard from IHSE into IP network. More secure than an IP network based on no unauthorized access. IHSE is isolated from the IP traffic if the IP network goes down. CADEX or fiber or universal UNI UNI SFPs for SDI, HD, or 3G SDI, or fiber. Hot swappable switch technology for power, I/O modules, and controller. We can create a single matrix grid up to 16 switches deep. And separately, up to 16 users can view the same screen at the same time. IHSE has a configuration tool on our website used by consultant firms, by any end user who is looking to design a network with IHSE chassis and populate our cards and mix and match different boards. This tells you exactly what can be done, including the power consumption and the current ratings. Now I have a live demonstration to point out a few key features. This concludes the IHSE session. Contact 42U for assistance with designs, product demos or evaluations, and quotes. Thank you for your interest in IHSE High Performance KVM Solutions. Here I have a demonstration kit set up. This is a true demonstration kit, a live network running. We sell these in different configurations in the military, as well as field production for rental and staging. So what I have here is two monitors. We have on this upper six-bay chassis, we have four CPUs, which are within this chassis, and the green cables go to four HDMI CPU modules. They then go into an eight-port switch integrated into the six-bay chassis. On the console side, the red cables come out and go to workstations. We have the first workstation, DVI, the second workstation, HDMI, with an audio board, and the third workstation with a USB. This is also HDMI. As you can see, my keyboard and mouse are plugged into the right side workstation. And the OSD is accessible through any of the workstations and CPUs as well. Simply by clicking a hotkey, the OSD pops up. I can then go to different sources at any point and get my different monitors pulled up and CPUs. Now in addition, I can get deeper into the OSD as well. And at that point, go to different monitors, portray different sources on different monitors. Here we have the two different workstations set up, the right and the left, and what I can do is control what happens on the right or the left. The left one should then portray what I had on the right. So all this can be done in an event, in concert, in a studio, and there's much, much more to the OSD for control. But these are just some basic applications. Next, I want to show the speed of the frame changes in terms of source to source. So I have four different sources here. One, two, three, four. As you can see, there's no latency whatsoever, no jittery screens. 100% bandwidth goes to signaling.